After the successful Chandrayaan 3 mission to the moon, ISRO announced India's first solar mission, Aditya L1, to study the sun, will be launched on September 2, 2023, from Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. In this video, let's see how Aditya L1 will be launched and how it works. Aditya L1 would be launched using PSLV C57 rocket, which uses PSOM exaboosters. This boosters can lift up to 320 tons of weight. In the payload fairing of the PSLV, the Aditya L1 satellite is placed. The PSLV undergoes 4 stages of ignition, with a total of 4 powerful engines used in it.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
At the PS1 stage, the boosters and PS1 engine from the rocket will get separated with ullage ignition, and the PS2 ignition will start, which makes heavy thrusting of PS2. Later, the payload fairing separation happens. Then, the PS2 separation will take place, followed by PS3 ignition and thrusting of PS3. Now the PS3 gets separated from the launch vehicle, and PS4 will thrust heavily by igniting. At the time of PS4 shutoff, the Aditya L1 will be placed in a lower Earth orbit. After the separation of Aditya L1 from the launch vehicle, it travels to Lagrange Point 1. This Lagrange Point 1 is around 1.5 million kilometers from Earth and about 148.5 million kilometers from the Sun. Let's understand the Lagrange Point 1. For a two-body gravitational system, the Lagrange points are the positions in space where a small object tends to stay if put there. These points in space for a two-body system, such as the Sun and Earth, can be used by the spacecraft to remain at these positions with reduced fuel consumption. Technically, at Lagrange Point 1, the gravitational pull of the two large bodies equals the necessary centripetal force required for a small object to move with them. For two-body gravitational systems, there are a total of 5 Lagrange points, denoted as L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. Lagrange Point alone lies between the Sun and Earth lines. The Aditya L1 will be placed in a lower Earth orbit. Subsequently, the orbit will be made more elliptical, and later the spacecraft will be launched towards Lagrange Point 1 by using onboard propulsion. As the spacecraft travels towards L1, it will exit the Earth's gravitational sphere of influence, SOI. After exiting SOI, the cruise phase will start, and subsequently, the spacecraft will be injected into a large halo orbit around Lagrange Point 1. The total travel time from launch to L1 would take about 4 months for Aditya L1. This is how Aditya L1 satellite gets deployed in its orbit, and Aditya L1 is expected to have a lifespan of 10 years. Let's see how Aditya L1 will work. Aditya L1 carries 7 scientific payloads for the systematic study of the Sun. All payloads are indigenously developed in collaboration with various ISRO centers. 4 out of 7 payloads will carry out remote sensing of the Sun, and 3 will carry out in situ observation. Payloads are wrapped with multi-layers of insulation. Firstly, the visible emission line coronagraph VELC is used for studying the solar corona and dynamics, the origin of coronal mass ejections, and the magnetic field of the solar corona. Second, the Solar Ultraviolet Imaging Telescope, SUIT, that will be used to take images of the solar photosphere and chromosphere. Third, the Aditya Solar Wind Particle Experiment, ASPEEX, payload comprises 2 subsystems, SWIS and STEPS. SWIS, also known as Solar Wind Ion Spectrometer, is a low-energy spectrometer that is designed to measure the proton and alpha particles of the solar wind. and steps. Suprathermal and energetic particle spectrometer is a high-energy spectrometer that is designed to measure high-energy ions of the solar wind. Fourth, the plasma analyzer package for Aditya PAPA will be used to study the composition of solar wind and its energy distribution. Fifth, the solar low-energy X-ray spectrometer, which will be used to monitor the X-ray flares in order to understand the heating mechanism of the solar corona. Sixth, a high-energy L1 orbiting X-ray spectrometer HEL-10S that will be used for observing the dynamic events in the corona. The seventh will be the magnetometer onboard. Aditya L1 is meant to measure the low-intensity interplanetary magnetic field in space. It has two sets of magnetic sensors, one at the tip of a 6-meter deployable boom, and the other in the middle of the boom, 3 meters away from the spacecraft.